through the estuary, across the mouth, and into the shadows of the opposite shore. The wonderful expanse of sun-baked sand, and a potentially good sunbed. Back in the estuary, the tide is almost at its highest, and the current subsides. The mullet run comes to a temporary halt. They mill about, waiting for the tide to turn, and rush out of the bay, carrying them into the ocean where they can finally spawn. In the meantime, they take advantage of the estuary's facilities, inviting the loons to give them a quick makeover. The smaller fish delicately pick off parasites and dead scales from the mullets' bodies. Those in need of more thorough service enlist the help of a full-time fish cleaner, the cleaner lass. And if its client stays still long enough, an internal check of the gills is provided as part of the service.
She's stretching apart.
Only then will time be absolutely right for a final one to spawn. There are now many thousands of mullets congregated in the estuary.
She's literally stretching. She's stretching.
Thirsty.
Then the king of ocean hunters makes his entrance. A Zambezi shark uses him, bold and confident.
Yeah, it's like that. Now, what's it called? I don't know. That smart water I put in their bottle. I put some smart water in their bowl. I only get my scorpions the best.
From all sides. They even become airborne to try to get away. But for some, there is no escape. With great precision, the Zambezi seal fish at every bite. Shoals of smaller mullets employ the same flying technique to